Wait. Now, ready. What do you want?
Hello, CDVD. My name is Jero Nyoman Sumerta. I'm the owner of this place. Here in this place, we have first time I have a gallery, Sumerta Gallery. And then I have my restaurant. I make it 1999. My gallery, I start from 1981. And then also I build my villa 2002, and then I start my whole business and step by step from start from 1981, and now it's already 2024. I have a brand. I have 30 restaurants all over Indonesia. We have 7 restaurants in Bali. We have 11 restaurants in Jakarta and somewhere.
Okay. Really?
Yeah. I will tell you my story. Yeah. When I start my business or my job, 1975, I was a memo driver. I start from Ubud, I wake up in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning, and then I go to Denpasar, sometimes 4 times, 6 times a day, going back for public car, and then I back home 8 o'clock in the night. Sometimes I work 14 hours a day, but I'm enjoying my job, I'm always happy. And also, in the same time, I'm also a taxi driver. From 1975 until 1981, you know, sometimes I'm guide, but my English not so well. But I just try to do it, you know. And then I go around with the guests from Holland, from all over the world. Sometimes I accompany guests with my motorbike. Sometimes with motorbike, I ride motorbike. I go around Bali, you know. I get some money. But my hobby is I like art. I like to make a wood carving. I like to dance, you know. I like to dance, and I like to painting. I like to play gamelan. That's why now I have. I buy already 3 group of gamelan. I have 3 group of gamelan. I have 3 sanggar. You know, 1 sanggar, 50 people. You know, play gamelan and the dancer all together 50 people. You know, because my hobby is art. You know. And then after I finish my job in taxi driver and public driver, and then 1981, I start to make gallery. I borrow my father's house, you know. Then I borrow my father's house to make gallery, because when I was taxi driver, I go to somewhere bring a company guest and I get commission. And I know how to make money, and then I mix my gallery, but I borrow the painting because I don't have money, no capital, and borrow painting of my friend, and then I sell in my father house. That's 1981. And then I have a dream, one day I like to have a big gallery, I like to buy land. After 1989, I buy the land in this place. In this place at Sumerta Gallery. Then I build here, start from 1,000 meter. I buy 10 acre in Bali, 10 acre, I bought 1,000 meter. And then, step by step, now this place already more than 3 hectare, more than 30,000 meter. In this place, now we have a gallery, we have a big collection, and also, I like to support Balinese artists. That way in my gallery, you can see my collection, the most is Balinese artists. Style from the style of the painting, from Tebasaya style, from Tongosekan style, from Batang Tegal, Kutu, Penestanan, Kelungkung, Kamasan Kelungkung. I show you later. I have so many painting in my gallery. Before I have more than 500 painting. One day my dream, when I have enough money also, I like to build my museum, even very small, my private collection I will put in my museum. For the public and the children can see what I'm doing, what I'm doing, and then I can show to the children, and then to keep the culture for the children, for the future. Like. That we also, in this area, I build a small palace we call Puri Duko. Also this place, I like to keep the architecture of Bali. That's why I keep the buildings original, and also I keep the rice field with my business. How I make the business, I still keep the rice field. That's why around here, we still have rice field. Yeah, that's the thing I'm doing. And also, I love Bali culture very much. That's why I must keep. You know that. I didn't want to talk only, but I want to doing, not only talking. We are doing. You know. Okay. Yeah. That. Thank you.
Okay. When you want, please.
Also, I like to tell you about the story of my restaurant, because my restaurant very very famous. You know, all of our president in Asia, or the prime minister from other country, they visit my restaurant because my crispy duck, very very famous. The recipe from myself and my wife. You know, because I'm get success because I love art. That's I'm thinking. I love art. The painting is art. Woodcarving is art. Dancing is art. It's food also art. And how I make the food look beautiful. When you look, you already interesting, you know, because beautiful also surround, and then yeah, how to make crispy duck. Of course, I use traditional recipe from our old generation. You know, it's very simple, you know, recipe, you know, but very, because my English not so good, very hard to explain. Of course, yeah, we use onion, chili, many, many things, all is original, you know. From our Bali tradition, that is not new. This is tradition of Bali. And then we prayed. Yeah, for the prayer is 7 minutes. We prayed. It can tell you about how long I prayed 7 minutes. Yeah, like that. Before I prayed, of course, I put water, hot water, and then the duck, and then we put recipe after a few minutes, and then we can fry it. You know, and then we can. We give also sambal mata, balini sambal goreng, balini sambal also, and also sayur urap, we call vegetable, yeah, just like that. And then our president, like Mr. Jokowi, more than 10 times to visit my restaurant, because they miss my bebek, my crispy duck, you know? Yeah. Yeah, that's it, yeah.
And please, can you tell what means the duck for the Balinese culture?
Yeah. You know, in Bali, the duck is very, 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 we call holy duck. Why holy duck? Because the duck in Bali we use for ceremony. When we have ceremony in the family temple or a big temple, we always use duck. You sometimes smoke duck, sometimes crispy duck, and also the duck put for priest, you know. Usually we give priest only duck, because duck is holy food for Balinese people, for Hindu religion in Bali. Thank you.
Thank you.
My father, my mother, that's me.
Can you explain again, please?
That's me. That's my father and mother, but already passed away.
So sorry. Yeah. So where we go now?
Okay, we go to gallery.
Wait, excuse me.
This is my gallery.
Wait there.
We, yes, go to the gallery.
Okay.
Yeah. You see this painting? That's about the story about in Bali, you know, Barong. Barong is good spirit. This is about then we call Arja. During the ceremony, the temple always we have performance with Arja then. We call Arja. Yeah, this is the life of Balinese people in the farmer. Yeah, this always traditional style. This we call Kamasan style. This is Tebasaya style. This is Pak Sade style from Penestanan, Penestanan village. Yeah. This way. Oh, this one. This one. This Penestanan village. We call young artist style or naive style. This
one. Naive style.
Naive style. This way. And about this artist, is Balinese, his name is Mr. Gunarsa. He is a Balinese artist, but he already work in modern art. Maybe this we call impressionist style, very quick. You know? But Balinese object, but in modern techniques. Yeah, yeah. Balinese object is a painted dance. This painted dance. This is a this artist from. He live in Bali. He is from Europe, you know, but he live in Bali. His name is Mr. Blanco, but he already passed away also. Yeah, already passed away, Mr. Blanco. He live in Ubud. He always make object with naked woman. He love Balinese woman.
me too.
Yeah, yeah, it's normal. This way. This way. You see here because I have so many collection. I like to support, you know. I like to support Balinese artists, but I don't have enough wall to hanging. That's why so many painting. That's why I have dream to have museum, but we need. I have the land already, but I hope one day I have money.
And you can have support from the government to make the museum. No, they don't have money for that.
No support.
Okay. If it's your dream, you got it.
Yeah, I just my dream, but I think I will do it.
Yes.
My dream will come true.
Yes. I agree.
Yeah, there's also many traditional painting. Yeah, this we call Batuan style. It is small thing, this is Batuan style. This artist also very famous, but Mr. Bendy is already passed away also. This is one of the famous Balinese artists. Yeah.
And what you can say about the booth artwork, the booth?
The wood cafe?
Yes, it's amazing work.
Oh, yeah. Because before I have also one shop special for wood carving in mass, but now I closed it because of the situation of the economic, you know, and then I put some of my collection here. Yeah. This is we call men brayut. One girl has many children. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, many. The Balinese girl with many children.
Yeah.
We call her name men brayut. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, this also not the one men brayut. You see this one? Same, but different style, but same idea. See? This how many children? This one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9. Yeah.
Before in Spain, our family has 14, 15 children. Yeah. But before.
Also in Bali, we have 12. One mother, 12 children.
12 children.
Yeah.
So.
I think it's enough. Now we can see
yes.
my
one. Amsiastiastu.
Amsiastiastu.
We go to see the villas.
Wow. In this villa, I plant many orchid. I love orchid. I like, you see every corner is art. That's my idea.
Yes.
Every corner is art. You look there, art. Look here, art. Look here, art. Everything, everywhere is art. Create with art.
The garden is art also.
Yeah.
Because you have
all is art. That's
beautiful
it.
Garden.
Yeah. This robot. What's his name?
Sirimiri.
Sirimiri.
He's the first robot reporter.
Yeah.
Hello,
from
Sirimiri.
Spain.
How are you?
Thank you.
our room. You see every room we have gates. Balinese.
House the tradition always with gates and also we have opening. Berapa tuh ini untuk selamat itu teman? Untuk biar selamat itu bahasa Inggrisnya.
Offering is canang. Canang is derived from the word cha and nang. It means a good deed to propose to thank to the God for what we have for today. So we serve the offering is to thank to the God for what we have.
Yeah. To have a beautiful island like Bali.
She speaks good
thank
English.
So yes. Thank you so much.
But his English is good. Everybody can understand. Yes, he say he feel like it's not good, but
this way.
I can understand very well. Thank you.
Can I have your name?
Peyo.
Peyo.
We have rice pill here also. From the room,
this is a rice pill.
Rice pill.
It's very nice view.
Beautiful.
And you can feel the authentic of Bali.
Yeah.
Is available by seeing the rice field and also coconut tree.
Yeah.
You know the man of coconut tree is everything inside the coconut tree is value. Starting from the fruit, we use it, we can eat. From the leaf, we use it for offering. For the trunk, we use it for a bridge. And even for the root, we use it for rope.
Uh-huh.
So all in one tree is really useful.
I love coconut tree.
Yeah, and the water is a detox for your health.
Yes. I drink coconut water every morning.
So that's why my owner really love to plant coconut tree.
Yes, thank you.
Before this place, all is rice field. And then I buy 100 coconut tree, I plant here with 100 coconut.
100 coconut?
Yeah. Dulu sawah di sini semua. Ya.
How many villas do you have?
26.
In total, 26.
26 villas. Do you have a special villa, like suite, special villa?
Yes, we have.
Yes, we have 4 suites and 2 swimming pools.
Uh-huh.
Pak Depet monitor. Pak Di. Kamar suite yang available yang bisa di showing ke Pak Theo?
Ya, 104 ya, seperti dia pilih. Ini satu cukup satu. Ya,
206 ya.
Pastu restoran for breakfast.
Oke.
Yang sudah bersih apa? Ini ada wartawan mau
itu. Oh, ya, for Japanese food ya.
Uh-huh.
Western food.
206 ya.
I think you like you see the harping of the
bathroom. Wow. Beautiful.
You go this way, you can see still rescue. You have a lot of orchids.
You know the carving? The name of the carving is Boma, representing forest plant vegetation.
What?
It's Boma. The name of the carving is Boma, representing forest vegetation. It's a plantation of the forest.
Okay.
Ini lagi dingin, ini lagi dingin.
So Boma is the son of Siwa.
Ini orang-orang dari sawah, the life of Balinese people.
So this one is the carving for Balinese people.
Balinese life,
working at the rice paddy field. This one, they are harvesting. So every corner is an art, and this one is seeding. This one, planting or seeding.
Okay. The rice field.
So, and do you use the rice for the restaurant? Of course, no?
Yeah. But every 4 months we cutting rice.
Every 4 months?
1 year, 3 times.
It's 3 harvests a year?
Yeah.
Okay.
This will be finished today. We have to.
Okay.
No pressure.
Noise.
No.
No noise.
No noise,
like outside.
Yeah.
This our bar, yeah? Bar. Very, if you want to have some drink. Yeah.
Very important. Hello.
The swimming pool is also with the color umbrella of a green, so we want to match with the nature.
And the orchids.
In every corner you can see.
I make a lot of pictures yesterday of the orchids. Where do you get this collection of orchids?
I get from my friend.
From your friend? Yeah. Wow, because it's
I export my friend to make money and I buy from him.
It's beautiful. I love orchids. For me, maybe the most beautiful flower.
Thank you.
Yeah, we have
perfect
room,
perfect
pool.
Ganesha on the door.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Wow. The bathroom here.
Nice to be a honeymoon. Funny honeymoon here.
You see, this is original painting because I have so many paintings. This is original, all original. Because I have many paintings. Itu lukis mahal-mahal ini.
Kelihatan?
Oh. Itu kalau jual bisa 20 juta.
Kelihatan itu mahal.
How do you say in Balinese? Bagus.
Bagus.
And this is Buddha, no?
Yeah, Buddha.
Buddha. Om Namah Shivaya.
Bathroom, you look at
the bathroom.
Bathroom?
Wow. Is it a bathroom or is it a house? I can go into the picture. Wonderful, with ducks.
Yeah.
All with ducks.
Yeah.
Beautiful. And monkey.
Okay.
Yes. Beautiful. Good job.
Yeah.
Good job.
I love art.
Girls.
Everything I do with art.
Yes. This art of living.
Yeah.
Yes. When you want.
Hello, Shidi Midi. Now I will explain how to cook crispy duck. This is the recipe we use. Chili or lombok, pepper, bawang putih or white onion, this jahe, kunyit, this tingke, garam, salt, this oil, this ray, then lemon. Yeah. We just mix all together and then we boil the duck with the water with all of this a few minutes or let's say maybe 20 minutes and then after the recipe go inside the duck and then we take the duck and then we pray it, just like that. We pray it like 7 minutes is enough and then we put we give also some vegetable and then rice.
What is the customer, what they say after try the duck?
Oh, most of the customer very, very delicious. Very special. Only, it's the best crispy duck, you know, in Indonesia. The best one. That's why all Indonesian president or all minister visit this place. come here for crispy duck.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. Yeah.
Jero Samorta.
You're welcome.
Nice to meet you. Yeah. Hopefully we can come back again to Ubud to make something nice with the children of Ubud.
Yeah.
We love art too. And thank you to support the local and artist people.
This is original Balinese recipe from 100 years, not new.
Suksuma.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
You are welcome.
Hello.
Hello.
Mr. Duck?